we're gonna do a, when I'm doing a, when I'm recording anything, everybody does this differently, but I keep a, like, I'll have a set of notes for the song, and I do it, I have a, like, if I have 8 takes, so I'm just, I mark, draw out the whole tune bar by bar. A lot of people do this differently. I have a set of notes that I've learned to be able to do. I can just make a note, that means bad, that's okay, better, that's really good. If I have an F like that, that's fast on the time. I have a whole list of shorthand notes that I've come up with over 40 years, but it's good if you can come up with your own system. So notes are either bass parts or vocals are going by so fast. You know, if you can just go by and have notes bar by bar of everything, that's great. Mm-hmm. You don't have to go back and listen to them all. You do 10 vocal takes, you gotta go back and listen to them all again. You do 10 vocals, at the end of the vocal, I can just go write down the numbers and have a vocal take.
And then he's got his numbers of takes 1 through 8, for instance. Those correspond to my takes in Pro Tools, right? So we're using Pro Tools, and it has a feature. I don't know how familiar everyone is with Pro Tools. Mm-hmm. This is just what we use, but most programs that let you record do a similar thing. So you can see we have our 3 bass tracks right here, 1 for the DI, and then 2 tracks mm-hmm. for the 2 mics. So they're called the different takes. We put them on what are called playlists in Pro Tools. So you can see right here, I can select between the different. We have like 0.01, then I can make 0.02. So mm-hmm. what we can do is he's keeping his notes, and then at the end of the take, we can go through and we can go, we like the verse from 1,
mm-hmm.
and we can, follow the notes that he's taking, and we say, okay, we're take 6, and then, you know, we record on take 6 in Pro Tools, and it keeps everything very organized. So
At the end, I can just draw out a set of numbers to here, paste that together, you know.
Yeah.
So I can, I was thinking I can try both picks and also the thumb. So which is going to be less edgy, maybe.
I kind of like the sound of the pick.
Let's do it.
On this tune?
Yeah, sure. It's all a question of, it's...
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if if verses should be thumb or, you know. Let's try one through all the way through.
Sure.
Pick one.
Because
we'll let you hear the tune again anyhow. If,
Yeah, please.
Come in and start the top end of the second verse, and I'll punch in before the break. But.
Okay, cool.
And I've been doing just fine. Gotta be down because I want it all. It started out with a kiss. How did it end up like this? It was only a kiss. It was only a kiss. Now
I have to switch between pick and
yeah. It should just, maybe it should just sustain without.
I guess, yeah.
So getting for the bridge?
Yeah.
Two bars.
He's hitting those accents on the very end on the drums he's got on the last time around. Hear the song a few times over and over.
Because I have to switch with my fingers.
You didn't punch me, you keep coming right on the bridge. We're not punching those down to the bridge.
Right.
Yeah. Just right.
There you go.
I never
I still can't do better.
We'll try one more from the top. I wasn't sure that if that first verse was completely nailed either. So we'll do one more from the top.
Sure.
Let's just do one more from the top. We'll stop the punching.
Of course.
We should be sounding good.
We need to have one bass and then we can punch in details. He does that little thing that I...
Yeah.
I like that. It's just the right part. Let's do, keep that, you know.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
But when something works, like...
Yeah. Cut something and we'll listen down and see if we want to punch anything on it.
Sure.
We just do. So just do three, like. Then. I think we'll just do three, like, all the way up to the.
So what I'm gonna do is make a new playlist and we label it comp. right? Mm-hmm. And we'd chop all the different takes up.
But just cut in the last... the last bar, the first chorus from two, the bridge from two.
So I'm just going through and putting fades on the edit points.
Mark?
Yeah?
The question is that you can see the first track, you know, the upper one. We can see many peaks on it, even in the digitizer. While the second one is pretty, like, real tiny, so do you care about this? Is it all right?
Yeah, the first track is a direct track, which has a lot of dynamics. I'm not even compressing it to tape right now, or to Pro Tools. The second track there is a super distorted amp, so there's not much dynamics or attack on that. All three of them right now, including that direct where you're seeing all the attacks on, that's actually running through another distortion in Pro Tools right now. So if you actually saw the output of it, pros that, it would be pretty flat too.
The question was about, I'll translate this, the question was about, is the peaks, is it an issue? Because there were some peaks in the first track.
Some clips.
Clips.
A few overs.
Not on this track. There's so much distortion on this track. Yeah, there's so much distortion. I mean, this track is kind of built around just so much distortion. He's saying the monitoring after the added distortion, and that's because actually without this gain on here, it's not clipping. So it's just this added gain that I'm putting on the distortion, which is where it's showing the clips.